This is Thomas, and I'm Christian. And there's been a lot of talk about collaboration today, so we thought that we want to show that we can actually collaborate between IT and the business and do this together. I hope you're still awake this late afternoon and ready for the next presentation here. Today it's World Water Day. So we have I've heard a lot of presentations today about what is the value we are creating. What is the impact? So think about that more than 600 million people are without clean drinking water. More than 2.4 billion people are without sanitation. That's a real problem. And as a company, Grundfos, we are actually determined to do something about it. Thomas will show a case where we'll show where we will do something about these issues, but also how we will use augmented reality to do that. Grundfos, we are supplying containerized wastewater treatment systems, and it's a problem when these systems are installed if they are not maintained in a good way. And being decentralized systems, getting access to operators and maintenance people that are really skilled and trained is not so easy. Actually, would you like to work in the wastewater business if you can do data science? Not really. So getting these people on board is a little difficult, but. Take us through that, Thomas.
So you can hear me, right? Yeah. Okay, so this is just one example of a kind of project that we work with. And to understand what's on the picture, on the right-hand side, right here, there are some of these actually big filtering units. So this is a water purification system, a complete system that we can put on remote areas or anywhere in the world, and you can get clean drinking water. What you also see are some dashboards, and you see it right down here some data points that have been connected, and they have different colors. They're green, they're good, yellow, not so good, basically. And the business case of this that we're presenting is basically that if you buy one of these installations, one of these systems, you can pick your plan. So you can either get it as your own asset and we stay away, or you can choose to actually get some of these guidance and the manuals we have, that support, maintenance support. You can also just choose to actually have the little bit extended version, which is an AI-enabled kind of setup we've done, and I'll tell you more about that later. And you can also choose to pay a little bit more, and you will at any point of time be able to get an expert real-time together with you in the system, in the facilities. And well, it should be pretty easy, right? We have, by the way, the word easy is one of the words right now that I will almost fire people for using. It is not easy, but it should be, right? It's about one connected system. It's about one field engineer that has to be able to use the smart glass. There's one of those too. And then it's the data platform. It should be really easy. But the case that we're showing here is actually trying to explain you why something that seems easy can be used to drive a lot of transformation in the company. And that's what it's about. One of the first complications is getting the data value chain up and running. So just connecting stuff and getting the data into the system in the way we want is a challenge sometimes. And then getting the data kind of wrangled into the model and then apply the model. There's a long chain of things that have to be in place before we can actually go to a customer and say, we're pretty certain that we can create value for you because you want these information, these dashboards, and these analytics. And it's a big thing, and we'll talk about more about that later. This is one of the ways you can see our architecture. And it's not really for you just to kind of understand the architecture. It's more for you to understand that there are a lot of components themselves that have to be implemented and put into governance in order for this to be able to work right and create value with. And some of the things that we do think are interesting, and the use case you saw, we're right now establishing this AI-guided landscape that appears in the smart glass. And we're using a lot of different technologies to make it happen. And we're combining, and that's what I think is the most interesting part. We're combining, you know, the basic stuff with the rule-based AI and the data-driven AI stuff. And it's a really cool project. But the message is, it's also very difficult to get is to kind of scale. And that's what our talk is about.
Yeah, so the example here is that Thomas shows is this: we sell some equipment, and then we sell some service, easy service on top of that. Where we really want to be is where we sell and provide water as a service. And what you show, what we show here, is kind of one single POC that goes all the way through. So we can succeed in doing that. The challenge that then we see when we want to scale and really create a more value and more impact is that Grundfos as a company, we have 8 major product lines. We have 4 businesses that each tap into these products. Then we have more than 20 applications across these businesses. And then we have a lot of different users. So so this example is just one line across all these different dimensions. So when we are going to scale, we need to understand all the products, we need to understand all the applications, we need to understand all the customers. If we are taking that one by one, it's going to take a long time. So we need to be smart and clever here. So basically, yeah.
Just to exemplify this, I'm going to ask you, how many product numbers do you think we have? Active product numbers, mm-hmm. So goods that we sell. You'll pick a number in your head, and I'm going to tell you what it is, and I'm going to ask you to raise your hand if you thought if you're below the number that I tell you. Okay, everyone has a number in their head. Like, it's real products you can order. All our customers, in theory, can go in on the extranet and order these products. So the number is 100,000 plus. And that's the complexity that we're dealing with, also when we start talking about connected systems.
So that's why, even with a nice POC, kind of the opportunity is, we can show it's there, but building it, that's actually something to do here. We need to build many on tops, or we need to be really clever to hit the right one. And then on the other axis, I show here, that's the feasibility. So how easy is it actually to take this opportunity and bring it into the market and do many of those? And what we want to talk a little bit about is how we actually orchestrate and how we put the organization together in order to enable our people to scale this. We have three ways of looking at our organization. One way is the business startup teams that do the POCs. But another area are the capability teams. Those are the specialist teams that are organized in groups in the business that really are the same type of people, so they can exchange knowledge. And then the third one is how we orchestrate the network organization, so people actually can work quite easily together. So this is an example of, or this is how we orchestrate the teams that do the POCs. All these different types of people are in these teams. And then they are put into one big office, these teams, and you have the business developer, you have the data scientist, you have the data engineer, you have the project manager, and they are sitting together, closely together. They are then hired in the core organization, in these specialist groups, and the way we then exchange knowledge across is both when we meet weekly and monthly, but also via our social media network. And I want to show you today exactly how we do it, not just some graphs about it. But this is a post from this week. This is the working out loud from Monday. So the people in our teams, they create this. What am I going to do this week? What are my results from last week? And who do I need to work together with? So the working out loud from Monday, of course, I posted in the working out loud, I'm going to this conference, what I'm going to talk about. So now people know about that. But Tuesday afternoon, when I made this snapshot, more than 222 people actually went in and read this working out loud. So now they all know what each other are doing. It's a very effective way to actually make people work across in the network.
Is it me now?
Yeah, it's you now.
Okay. Yeah. So basically, the talk is about transformation, right? And creating value in the organization. It's not about the technical solutions. That'll be another session. This is the picture of, you can say, how we try to put our organization together. The X stands for crossover. So actually, my vision is certainly a network organization. I want a real network, of course, based on a certain number of centers of excellence, and we need some power out in the business areas. We can't have, I mean, it won't work with one big data science team of 25 people or 50 people that way. We need to have the data scientists out in the business areas so that we can roll the learning and the algorithms continuously. So it's a crossover between a kind of hub and spoke and network. There's some numbers up there. You can say these communities that tie a network together. The one key measure you should look for is engagement on quality content, you can say. And we have more than 300 people actually weekly being part of that conversation. That's how we spread the word. That's how we get ideas for new business projects. So we have these data business spotters going on. So, hey, I have this problem, I have this idea, you know, could we use those data to fix that problem? Or could we make this part of a digital offering that we're already trying to do? Those types of conversations. Actually, the number is not here. We had, for the last 6 months, we've had 900 plus, can you help me with this, conversations. Meaning that one data scientist, because I mean, even though they're good, right? They're really good, a lot of them. But each of them have their edge. They're a little bit special, right? Some are really skilled in deep learning. Some are really skilled in time series, stuff like that. So they help each other a lot. That's the main issue. And yeah, trust and transparency. Those are the words.
Trust and transparency, yeah. Because why do people actually look into the working out loud? So why do they actually ask each other these questions? Well, of course, we expect it from people. But it's also because our people, they actually gain a lot. They are more efficient, so they can actually feel that they produce more and it's more fun to be at work. You see, this is just a picture of how it looks like every month when we do our big data lab hackathon. People, they come together in the same room. Now it's about the data science part. They come together in the same room. They sit and work on their task. They ask each other, so what are you doing? What am I doing? And then we put them together in small groups, and they are able to share and exchange knowledge here. We think it's actually crucial to our success in digital transformation. What is it our CEO he expect from us to make the smartest digital transformation in the machine industry, or is it even in a larger scale? And this is our contribution. We actually think the way we work and the way our people work in the daily work that's actually going to increase the feasibility of how we are able to scale these POCs. And we think it helps us to maintain people in our company, and we also think that it helps them to see the larger goal in what we're actually doing and moving towards the sustainability goal number 6 about clean water and sanitation.
That's it.
That's it.
And we have 5 minutes.
Yeah, yeah. But it's on purpose. We want to do it a little fast because we also want to open if you have any questions or comments to us.